Hey, what's up, guys? We landed in Nairobi, Kenya yesterday, and I knew in a couple videos ago, you can watch that video on the card showing up on your screen right now. I shared that I was going to be traveling out to Kenya with a group. Now I'm here with Outdoor Photography Guide, a company that I work for and with from time to time. And we came out here the last day. We've been doing like some touristy stuff. We went to an elephant orphanage, which was really fun. And then we've also just been kind of like driving around, going to local museums and things like that. But in a day, we're going to safari for 6 days. And I wanted to share kind of the gear that I brought along so that if you're going to safari in Africa or if you're going to shoot wildlife with your camera, this gear will not fail no matter what type of wildlife you're going to shoot. And be sure to subscribe to see the next videos on the safari in this playlist. But the first thing that I wanted to bring was a good wide angle lens. Now, if you've been watching my channel for a while, you've known that I typically use a Rokinon 12 millimeter, but for this one, I brought a Tamron 17 to 28 millimeter f2.8. This gives me enough room for wide angle zooms when I can't get as close as I want to some of the wildlife unless they approach the car. Then I can get down real low and shoot from a low perspective and kind of make that the subject matter and the hero of the photograph shooting at a low perspective and going up. So I wanted a good wide angle lens that was gonna allow me to do that and also a fast one that was gonna allow me to do that. So far, I've only been using this lens for 1 day. I was kind of nervous about just taking a completely new piece of gear out with me and using it to photograph in a completely new location as well. This lens has not let me down. The 70 to 28 has given me plenty of room to photograph wide angles and plenty of zoom to get some further back shots, especially creating like story travel photography when we were at the elephant orphanage as well. The next piece of gear that I wanted to bring along was a telephoto lens. And if you've watched this channel, like I said, with the wide angle, you know I use a 70 to 200 very often when I go out and shoot landscapes, but to get wildlife, I wanted to get really close. So what I did was I didn't want to purchase a lens of this size, not to mention I don't have, $7,000 to $10,000 laying around in cold hard cash just to drop on a lens like this for a week trip, something like that. So what I did was I rented this Sony 200 to 600 f5.6 to 6.3, a really, really good lens. And typically what I've done is I've rented from companies, but I found this new company. This isn't sponsored by them or anything. There's no discount code. I just want to show them some love because they have really good prices on their rental gear for their lenses. And that's called aperturerent.com. I got this 200 to 600 lens for like $250 for a 9-day rental. Actually, I think it was more like a 14-day rental. So that's a really good price for a lens of this size. Other companies, you're gonna be spending probably double that to get this for 2 weeks. But I wanted this lens to give me enough reach with a fast camera, like a smaller mirrorless Sony a6000. And that a6000, the crop sensor, is going to give me a little bit of a jump in that 200 to 600. It's gonna act more like a 300 to 900 millimeter lens for safari. So getting out really far away from those animals and being able to zoom way in on those is obviously a huge plus. Like I said before, these pieces of gear cannot fail you when you're going out to photograph wildlife. Even if you're going out to photograph landscapes and you just want to get really far off and stack those compressions together with something like a telephoto lens. Subscribe to this channel to continue following along on our safari journey or just watch the next video in this playlist.